Immigration?
Revenue.
Mrs. Rose, there are people here from the government.
I've been gutted. John, I've been stripped of every morsel of pleasure I earned in this life.
Well, how do you think I feel, Moira? Eli was family, for God's sake. Leave your finances to me, said son of a bitch.
Baby, it's crazy. People are just, like, taking our stuff. I said they're taking our stuff. Can you just step out of the club for a second? Please? Hold on. Those bags are not for you. My boyfriend bought those for me, so theoretically, they are his.
Please, sir, can you step aside?
No, you step aside. You step aside! I'm still trying to wrap my mind around what kind of a sick person wants to get paid to destroy another person's life. Destroy another person's life! Where are you taking that?
My very soul has been kidnapped. There's no ransom. No one's coming to save me.
We've got 15 minutes to collect our personals. Can we pick up the pace?
No. Did you put Christy with Robin? They don't like each other. No! No!
Eli really did a number, Johnny. He took everything. They're still looking for him. They think he's in the Caymans.
He was our business manager. He's supposed to pay taxes.
There is a very small amount set aside for you, and one asset the government has allowed you to retain.
The kids.
The children are dependents, Moira. You bought a small town in 1991, Johnny.
Yes, I bought that as a joke for my son.
Wait, you actually purchased that town?
Yes, I purchased the town. How else could I get the deed?
You could have photoshopped the deed.
And save the money.
Like, why
save the money.
Why would I photoshop a deed? The joke was owning the town.
Stop.
That was the joke.
Oh, my God.
Well, that was the joke.
To Johnny's credit, this town might just be your saving grace. At least for a while.
What do you mean?
You can live there for next to nothing until you get back on your feet.
I'm sure there's a penthouse we can move into. Please, there are other options.
Well, homelessness is still on the table.
Moira. Moira!
Oh, no. I just finally cried myself to sleep.
The bed's soaking wet.
Is it blood?
No, there's a leak in the ceiling. There's a brown, disgusting drip coming.
Look at,
oh my God.
I can't do
it. This place is a dump. It's a dump. You know what? It's a hellhole.
I tried, John, but I can't.
Wake up. Start packing. The plumbing is shot to hell in this place, and we are getting out. We're getting out.
What are you wearing? What is that, a nightgown?
It's a nightshirt, David, and that's not the issue. The issue is the brown sludge in my bed. We're selling the place.
It's 6 a.m.
What's the name of the mouthy kid at the front desk?
I don't know. I'm trying very hard not to connect with people right now.
The mouth, the girl.
You might want to rethink the nightgown first. There's a whole Ebenezer Scrooge thing happening.
Oh, that's what I was thinking of.
You know what? I'll do it myself.
Okay. My best to Bob Cratchit.
So this is the town limits?
Yes, sir. 4,500 acres that ends right here at the town sign. And it's all yours, Johnny. Must be a nice feeling considering you don't have a lot right now. You know, because of the crooked business manager. You know the money scam.
Yes, I know, Ray. What the hell is this?
The town sign.
Is this the real sign or the joke sign?
What do you mean?
You don't see anything wrong with this? The man, standing awfully close to that woman, wouldn't you say?
Well, he's holding on to her so she doesn't fall into the creek.
Look a little closer, Ray.
Well, it does need a little sprucing up.
Sprucing up?
It's very popular. People come from all over to take a picture with it.
I'll bet they do. You know what? This is coming down.
That's the mayor's family up there. That sign's been here over 40 years.
And you wonder why this place won't sell?
Oh, I think I see it now. His shoulders are too big.
Get in the car, Ray.
Oh,
David, can you come here, please? David, can you come in here, please?
What?
Well, come in here and I'll tell you.
Well, why don't you just tell me from there?
David.
You could have already told me.
I want to speak face to face.
Motels this size, we're basically always face to face.
In the same room?
Why are you yelling? I'm right here.
I want you to move your clothes.
I did.
Out of my closet. You've got t-shirts on hangers. I have nowhere to hang my clothes.
I'll put them over the t-shirts then.
Moira.
Alexis.
I don't know, it's David I want.
I need to speak with our daughter.
Good luck.
Oh my God, where did you hear that?
What is it?
I need you to fill this out, please.
Fill what out?
Your community service papers. As our only delinquent, I hope it's not asking too much.
Still have to do that?
Generally, that's how it works, honey. When you break the law, you've got to serve your sentence.
Well, it was one DUI.
Please, before I lose my mind.
I don't get it. It's all done.
No, there's still a little bit that needs to be filled in.
All that's missing is my middle name.
Then fill it in, please.
Do I have to do that?
Why must you be so constantly irksome?
Do you not know my middle name?
Of course I do. I blessed you with it.
Okay, so then what name should I put down then?
Alexis, do as your mother says, please.
Do you know my middle name?
If I said Anna...
I can't believe this.
Alexis something Rose. We have so many disasters bombarding us right now, my dear. The middle name of an ungrateful child is hardly a priority.
Wait, Alexis has a middle name? Why is this the first time hearing of this? Do I have a middle name?
Now you come into the room.
Could you spare some,
Oh my God, oh my God,
oh
my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh my God, what's happening?
I saw hell is what's happening. Oh my God.
Huh? Oh my God.
David, what you just saw was your mother and me.
I know what I saw.
Having an intimate moment.
I cannot unsee that.
Okay, and I refuse to feel guilty about being in bed with my wife.
Ew.
I hate to be the one to tell you, but having sex is not just about making children so they can grow up and make you feel bad about having sex.
Oh my God, can you stop this, please?
I will not be shamed. Shame on you.
Shame on you for attempting that position at 8 o'clock in the morning.
John?
You know what?
Oh my God.
Do you know how difficult it is for us to share a wall with you two?
I do now.
Yes, well, if you don't mind, we are now going back into our room and don't even think about opening that door.
Are you serious?
Next time. Hey, Moira, could you turn that down, please? Important call coming through. Stevie says it's the guy from the winery. Hello, Johnny Rose. Hello? Hello? Stevie!
I put it through!
Okay.
Who is it?
Herb Ertlinger.
Excuse me?
Herb Ertlinger from the winery. He's the only guy that's gotten back to me on my proposal, and now the... Hi! Hello? There's something wrong with the phones!
John, have her patch it through to the kids' room.
Yeah, patch it through to the kids' room!
Okay.
Very good suggestion. Kids? David, answer the phone.
He has his headphones in, he can't hear it.
Then you answer it!
Okay!
Hello?
Alexis, could you open the door, please? I'll take it.
No, sorry, you have the wrong room. He's actually in room 6.
Alexis, unlock the door, please!
Okay, no problem. Bye.
He's gonna call you back in your room!
No!
Hello?
Don't judge me for what I'm about to ask you to do.
Come inside, please.
What are you about to ask me to do?
It doesn't matter.
What?
That.
That's why you called me in here?
Yeah, look at it.
I'm looking.
No, look at it.
It looks like a bug trapped under a glass.
I googled that bug. It's some sort of demonic cricket that takes chunks out of your skin when provoked. Chunks is the word that Google used.
You googled a bug.
Yeah, I have a thing about bugs with milky exoskeletons. I have this irrational fear they're gonna crawl into my mouth and nest at night, so.
So, what do you want me to do, kill it?
No, I think I just need moral support while I slip a piece of paper under the glass with the bug and take the trapped bug and walk it outside.
Or we could just kill it.
No, that's not the way to go. Oh, oh my God! It's fleeing!
This is fast.
It's fleeing into the bathroom! That's why you use the cup method, because you keep it contained. Now it's just all out.
Well, I guess I don't even need to be here.
Well, it's hot. Now it's hiding somewhere in the darkness, waiting for nightfall. I can't sleep here. I can't sleep here.
Not with your mouth open, anyway.
That's not a nice thing to say to me.
You know, sometimes I forget what life was like before I knew you.
Bye-bye. Bye. Yep.
Okay. Hope you catch it.
I can hear it. I can hear it.
Mom, can you come here, please?
What?
I said come here, please.
You come here.
We got a big box sent to us.
We did?
It's a package.
Who's it from?
I don't know.
Oh, it's for me. Thinking of you. Dear M, hope this helps. I only wish I could do more. XOXO JSP. Justine St. Pierre. David. One of my dear friends is finally reaching out. And you know what? I knew it would be Justine. She could be an angry drunk, but we were always close.
Congratulations on your Allez-vous starter kit.
That frigid whore.
What's Allez-vous?
It's a scam. It's her stupid cosmetics company. It's a pyramid scheme for desperate housewives and struggling actors.
Well, how much can we make from this?
David, it's an insult. We're sending it back.
Well, apparently you can win an Audi.
What color?
A champagne Audi. Look at that.
As if you could ever sell enough of this crap to get a car.
Well, Christy Stubbs and her team out of Montreal have sold enough to get the car, so...
Don't believe everything you read, dear, please.
Burn it.
Except this mascara.
Hi, Johnny. Can we come in for a moment?
Yes, yes.
Thank you. Hello.
Oh, hi.
Is everything okay?
We've got some sad news.
Someone very close has died.
Sorry.
Oh.
You remember Bob?
No.
You broke into his cabin and had sex while he and his wife were in the next room?
Oh, that's Bob.
Yeah, Bob, he was on the town council. He's on the town council, yeah. Oh, Bob died.
No, not Bob. Bob's brother, Carl, died.
I don't know Carl.
We barely know Bob.
Carl thought so highly of you, Johnny.
Oh, really? Well, that's nice. No, I honestly don't know the man.
Well, understandably, Bob is pretty broken up by all of this. And he asked me to ask you if you'd be willing to be a pallbearer at Carl's funeral.
A pallbearer? Mm-hmm. At Carl's funeral? Well, I don't, I'm flattered. It's quite an honor to be.
I knew he would say yes.
And normally I would. But my back. I have back issues, honey. You know my
what?
Back. The thing with my back.
Your back. Oh, it's terrible. And his arms are so weak. Little muscles like corn nuts.
Yeah. We're just talking about my back, sweetheart.
It's awful.
I don't know what we're gonna tell Bob. He's gonna be so disappointed.
Yeah, yeah. Well, life can kick you in the teeth sometimes.
Well, that's not gonna help Bob out too much there, Johnny.
No, shouldn't bother Carl.
This was a good choice.
Yep. You make good choices.
This was a really healthy choice.
Well, I'm gonna go to work now.
Okay.
Which is where I should have been 15 minutes ago.
Stevie? Oh, Stevie!
What?
It's your dad. He saw me. Fuck.
It's the towels again. We need towels.
Your dad can't know about this. It's humiliating for me.
Stevie, is this where you keep the towels? If it is, I'd love a key. Okay, this is a face cloth and a bath mat.
Oh, I will get you some towels and I will bring them to your room.
Oh, I'd love to take them with me. I need them now.
Oh, no, 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 no. I will deliver them to your room.
Stevie.
Is everything okay?
Stevie.
Yes, I'm just a little tied up right now.
Is anyone in there?
What? No.
Are you in danger? Blink, if you're in danger.
Stevie.
That's really not necessary.
Okay, well, I'm going back to my room now, and I'm gonna call the police.
No, Mr. Rose, please don't call the police.
Dad, please just take the towels and go.
Oh. Well, I've got everything I need. Good seeing you both. What?
Fuck me!
What?
John, there's something in the bed!
What?
Something crawled up my leg and I can't see it!
What?
I can't see it!
Spider?
No! Something invisible, like lice or scabies or bed bugs!
Oh, we don't have bed bugs.
Oh, John, I can't afford to burn all my clothes!
Oh, boy, relax. Just relax. If we had lice, I'd have lice.
Guess who?
Dee Dee.
Hi, Momo.
What the hell?
I should have called, but I just thought it'd be really fun to come see my older sister in her new digs. You know, a little visit. Oh, do you really have lice? I'd hate to contract. Lice?
No.
Kids, just came in to remind you to keep Saturday open.
What's Saturday?
What's Saturday? It's your mother's birthday.
No, her birthday is the second weekend in May.
That's Mother's Day, honey.
I don't think so.
I just don't think that this is the year to be doing something big.
Oh, why? Because we're here in this town? All the more reason to do something.
I actually agree with David. Plus, I'm going to be in Chicago this weekend.
You're what?
Ted's taking me. We've been planning this for a super long time, so.
Well, can I come?
No.
Okay, here's a news flash for both of you. You're not going anywhere, and we're planning a surprise party for your mother.
No, that's not a good idea.
That's not a good idea?
Where would you even throw a party like that in this town?
I don't know. I haven't thought that through yet. Maybe Roland's house?
Listen to the words coming out of your mouth.
Then you plan it.
What?
Oh,
no.
Snap, David.
Talk to the hand, son, because the ears are no longer working.
Okay, oh that's God. Not at all how that works. Though.
Cancel your triple X's because the travel agent is out of the office.
It's so uncomfortable when he does stuff like
absolutely
that.
Absolutely not.
I feel so weird about it.
We're getting out. We're finally getting out.
Oh, my God. I made it!